Well, good day, everyone. I'm Caroline Stewart Reinhardt Stewart, class of 66, and I serve as a school chaplain here at Garrison. And I'm so pleased to welcome you to our annual Alumni Weekend Chapel. This is a wonderful time to renew friendships and also to remember those who have died. Personally, I was looking over the list in our class of 66, and we have several members that we all are going to miss. So it really is a good time to honor them and their legacy and what they meant to one another and to us. I invite you to use the chat button and let us know those that you are missing and those that you are renewing your friendships with. So again, a warm welcome. And now I want to lead us in the Garrison Forest School prayer. Let us pray. Look upon this school as a field which thou hast blessed, and watch over thy children, O Lord. Grant them to grow in wisdom and in strength. Let them know the joy of struggle, the happiness of work well done, the glory of friendship. May they offer to the world, wherever they may be, thy gifts of honor, purity of heart, and gentleness. And with each day that passes, may they have an ever-increasing assurance of thy love. Amen.
My grandfather was an avid gardener. He was a CPA by trade and was meticulous by nature. When I was young, I used to flip through his garden journals whenever I visited. Each day he would record in the small leather book the name, the time of the sunrise, the temperature, the humidity, which birds or pollinators he had noticed each day. He took copious notes on which pests or molds were affecting his prized irises and took great care to adjust accordingly the next growing season to avoid the same fate. To my 8-year-old self, I couldn't believe how much work could go into growing flowers. When I grew up and moved to my home 12 years ago, I started my own garden. I planted hydrangeas and lilac bushes, dahlias, poppies, echinacea, and black-eyed Susan. My grandfather helped me dig up some of his iris rhizomes from his garden that I replanted in my own garden. All spring and summer, I had a fresh bouquet of cut flowers in my home. And then I had children. Suffice it to say that as a full-time working mother, the gardening got pushed to the very end of the priority list. Last March, when quarantine began, despite the fact that all plans were canceled and we suddenly had nowhere to be, I still felt an immense amount of stress and anxiety from watching the news, figuring out how to help my children learn virtually, and protecting my family from the virus. I found myself escaping to what was, at one time, my garden. I started clearing old piles of leaves and pulling up the remnants of vines and weeds that had all but taken over. I dug up, separated, and replanted plants and flowers that had grown into each other's spaces. And I bought myself a small leather book, much like my grandfather's, where I mapped out my new garden plans and made notes of the daily happenings in my garden. And in the process of recultivating my garden, I cleared my mind and refreshed my spirit. Something else happened during those early days of COVID, when I felt so physically separated from friends and family. Not unlike the feeling that I felt after 9/11, I felt an undeniable urge to reach out and connect with my oldest and dearest friends, my friends from Garrison Forest, whether they were 10 minutes away or halfway around the world. I longed for the comfort and connection that you can only get from friends that you've known and who have known you since childhood. Now, I've been class news agent for 20 years, so I don't mean the kind of reaching out that I do each year. Basically, I stalk my classmates and ask them for a blurb. This time, I made phone calls and had hour-long conversations, or I set up Zoom happy hours, and a group of us would laugh and tell stories long into the night. We found out about job changes and moves we didn't know had happened, because they hadn't made the blurb. We shared the highs and lows of raising children. We learned that some of us were struggling in our marriages or with caring for aging parents. And we remembered time spent together as girls here on this beautiful campus. Someone brought up the time that we told a big brother to pick us up behind the gym because we wouldn't be caught dead in his old station wagon after Snowball. Or we remembered the blizzard of 1995, and it had caused all the other Baltimore private schools to cancel exams. But because it was Mr. O'Neill's first year, and he was from New England, we all had to take exams. He was used to the snow. Someone dug out an old VHS recording of our senior skits and our senior entertainment, and we remembered our tearful goodbyes after graduation, laughing that we thought it was the end of our world. And in the process of recultivating these friendships, I cleared my mind and refreshed my spirit. Life gets busy. Jobs and kids and moves take over, and sometimes all you can manage is a blurb. Old friendships can get pushed to the end of the priority list. Maybe it's because we know they will always be there, their roots deep and stable. Maybe it's because even after the passage of 5 or 10 years, we know we will fall right back into that special comfort, the seeds of which were planted so long ago. My grandfather passed away on Christmas Eve. When it was safe to see my grandmother, she gave me a hug and tucked a tissue paper wrapped package in my hand. In it were my grandfather's old gardening journals. As I looked at them this time, older and wiser, I realized that all the work he did to cultivate that garden was so very worth it.
The following members of reunion classes have passed away since their 2016 reunion. From the class of 41, Ann Thompson Abbott, Marion Farrell McAleenan, Linda Harden Tuck. From the class of 46, Dora Stewart Lewis, Christine White Mann, Marion Humphrey Milton, Priscilla Randolph. From the class of 51, Carol Corcoran, Bettina Lindsay Jenny, Virginia Shriver Raleigh, M. Elizabeth Blaylock Ridgely, Emily Wells, Elizabeth Rich White. From the class of 56, Susan Warfield Caples, Leola Armour McDonald, Wendy O'Brien Marsh, Eleanor Purvis McLennan, Rosamund Dana Putsch, Linda Aikenhead Seed, Cynthia Compton Starkovsky. From the class of 61, Cornelia Barnes, Margaret Swope Gans, Eleanor Merriman Hardy, Marion Harvey Upson, Barbara Chisholm Young. From the class of 66, Chance Fenwick Earl, Eleonora Marshall, Elizabeth Bishop Nolan. Margaret Henshins Stone, Victoria Woodward. From the class of 71, Ellen Jenkins. From the class of 81, Jennifer Gillen Rasmussen. From the class of 86, Chrissia Simkovich Johnston. From the class of 96, Sabrina Spradley Akrabawi. The following alumni have passed away since May 2020. from the class of 40, Mary Allison Millett. From the class of 43, Joan Riley Bershenall. Sylvia Babcock Weaver. From the class of 44, Eleanor Segerman Campbell. From the class of 45, Alice Hackney Allstat. From the class of 47, Shirley Aldrich Dager, Anne Hinman Lilly, Mariana Mead O'Brien. From the class of 52, Macy Putnam Janney, Jane Douglas Major, Ellen Glessner Wadsworth. From the class of 53, Evelyn Castles Smith DeGast, Brent Hoard Malarkey. From the class of 55, Anne Cooper Siling, Elizabeth Gans Woods. From the class of 57, Terry Livingston Farr, Linda Hamilton Panitz. From the class of 60, Virginia Harrison. From the class of 65, Susan Matthews Peltz. From the class of 70, Catherine Miller, Helen Palmer Stevens. And from the class of 97, Allison Haygood. It is our honor to remember these alumni who have meant so very much to our school family.
Reflection by Nancy Jenkins Offutt. I've so often tried, only to find the words as elusive as this grace they tried to describe. All I can say is it must have been part of this school from the beginning. And each generation has treasured it and been proud of it, as you are proud of a goodly heritage. Maybe it gives you confidence. Maybe you walk a little higher for knowing it's part of you. Maybe you're glad to share it. Maybe you take a special joy in meeting a challenge. It's like a little compass that over the years, in good times and bad times, today perhaps as never before, has kept Garrison Forest on course. Perhaps, last and most of all, it is a sense of belonging.
As we conclude our time together, I offer this as a benediction. Life is short. We do not know how much time we have to gladden the hearts of those who travel with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind. Amen.